Hello friends, this afternoon I want to show you how to answer this examination question, question 7 on the quadratic function. So this is a very simple question. I request you to pay attention so that you see how we go about answering this question. So question 7, part A is the question that we are looking at. This paper is from Examination Council of Zambia. The year is 2020, paper 2. And so the question 7a says, the values of x and y are connected by the equation y is equal to x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5, as shown in the table below. So it's always important to read the question. So here is the table that we have. And so the first question says, calculate the value of P. Then using a scale of 2 centimeters to 1 unit to represent 1 unit on the x-axis and 2 centimeters to represent 5 units on the y-axis. And then there's this range of values given and this other one here. Draw the graph of y is equal to x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5. And then there are other questions that follow. And so in the exam, you're going to be given your answer booklet. I have my answer booklet here, my pen paper, and also a graph paper for part 2 of the question. I have a graph paper also here. Here it is. We are going to answer this question fully. And so, the first question which says calculate the value of P is answered like this. So, we are going to have question 7a, part 1. And so we are going to write down the equation that we are given here. It's y is equal to x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5. And so the question says calculate the value of P. Now if you notice here, look at your table, 2 is found in the row for x values. So you have an x here. And all these numbers on top are representing x values. And the numbers down here are representing the y values. So we are going to make substitutions here. So where there is y here, we are going to put a p because p is in the line for y values. So we are going to have p here. P is equal to where there is x, we replace that with a 2, the one on top. So the p down here, you put where there is y. 2, you replace where there is x. And the reason why you are replacing where there's x, it's because 2 is an x value. There's x here, there's 2 there. So you're going to have 2 here cubed plus 4 times 2 squared plus where there's x, put a 2, minus 5. And so you take your time, you simplify. 2 to the power 3 is 2 times 2 times 2, 3 times, you get 8 plus 4 times 4 plus 2 minus 5. So here we're going to have 8 plus 16 plus 2 minus 5, which will give us 8 plus 16 is 24. 24 plus 2 is 26. Minus 5, we have 21. So our P is equal to 21. So now we have calculated the value of P, and as you can see, it carries one mark because it's very easy to find. Now we go to part 2 of the question, drawing of the graph. So I'm going to need my graph paper. Okay, I'll need my graph paper. I'll put this one here. And so the question says, using a scale of 2 centimeters to represent 1 unit, and also 2 centimeters to represent 5 units on the y-axis. So we are going to draw the graph of this function here. So let us see how we can draw. So the values of x are running from negative 4 up to positive 2. So you have to make sure that they fit on your graph paper, from negative 4 to positive 2. So the scale on the x-axis is 2 centimeters to represent 1 unit. Meaning when you start, for example, from 0, the next value should be 1, 2, 3, just like that. And then on the y-axis, you have negative 10 to 25. So we have to make sure that these two ranges fit on our graph paper. So I'm going to count here to make sure that my range fits. So we have negative 4 to 2. So if I put my my negative 4 here, my negative 3 will come here, negative 2 here, 0 here. So 0 could come here. If my 0 is here, then it means I'm going to have 1 here, 2 here. Now my x-axis is fitting here. What about the y-axis? So the y-axis, the values are running from negative 10 all the way to 25. So I have to make sure that my values for y also fit. So on the y-axis, it's 2 centimeters to represent 5 units. So from 0 here, we have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So it means my x-axis can be here. Okay, so now I'm going to use the red color here to draw my x and the y-axis. So we are going to draw the x and the y-axis here. Okay, so let us draw the y-axis right here. So we are going to draw right here. The y-axis will be drawn right here. Okay, we'll come down all the way up to here, and then we are going to have our x-axis here. So our x-axis is going to be drawn right here. Okay, even this side we need to draw our x-axis. Okay, so this is our x and the y-axis. So what we have here is 0 here, and then we have 1 here, we have 2 here. So we have 1 here, we have 2, we have 3, and then it goes all the way up to 4. Okay, so make sure that your values fit on this graph. Okay, so I should have moved my y-axis a step this side, but it's okay. Even where we have it here, we are going to have our 4 here, and we put our negative numbers there. We are going to put our negative numbers, and then we indicate here to say this is the x-axis, and then we are going to have 1 here. Oh, sorry, not 1. It's starting from 5, so 5 here, because the scale is 2 centimeters to represent 5. So 10 here, 15, 20, 25 there. Okay, so up to 25 there, and we can indicate y there. Down here we are going to have 5, negative 5, negative 10, and down we have up to negative 10. So we are now ready to draw our graph. So we are going to draw our graph now. We'll determine the points. So the way you determine the points now is like this. Okay, so here you have negative 4 comma negative 9. So negative 4 is here, and negative 9 will be somewhere between negative 5 and negative 10. And so since the scale is 2 centimeters to 5 units, it means we'll be skipping one line for us to count. So from negative 4 here, 5 is here. 5 is here. As you can see, negative 5 is here. And then from here, we can count from 5. We are going to skip one line. We'll skip this line here. From 5, we have 6 here. We skip another one, 7. We skip another line, 8. We skip another one, 9 here. So 9 is here. Okay, so I'm using a pen to count. Okay, so our 9 is there. And then we come to negative 3, 1. So negative 3 is here. And then again, for us to count one unit, we have to skip one line, one of these small lines. So from negative 3 going up, 1 is here. Here, where I have placed a mark. And then we come to negative 2, 1. Negative 2, 1 is also here. This is where negative 2 is. Negative 2 is here. And then our 1 is right here. We skip one line. Okay, so we go to negative 1 comma negative 3. So negative 1 is here, negative 3 is down here, because the negative numbers are down. So here you are going to be skipping one line. So from here you are going to have negative 1, skip another line, negative 2, and then negative 3 right here. You put a mark, then we can continue just like that. We go to 0 comma negative 5. So 0 is here, negative 5 is here. right here. So I can even use a black marker there just to show clearly what we are talking about. So here, okay, so this is where our points are. Here, here, and there. And so that is where 0, negative 5 is. And then we have 1, 1. So 1 is here. So for us to go up one step, we are going to skip one line. So our 1 will be here. Just skip one line. The next one, that is where 1, 1 is. And then the last one is 2, 21. 2, 21. So 2, 21. 2 is here. Remember, we got the P. The P, let me put it here so that you can see. Our P is 21. So we calculated P to be 21. So we are going to have 2, 21. So we'll go up to where 20 is, and then we just skip one line, and then we are at 21 here. Okay, so now at this stage, now that we have all the points in line, it's time to sketch our graph. It's now time to sketch our graph. So we are going to sketch our graph now, to draw our graph by following the points that we have. So it's a freehand method. Don't use a ruler, just use your free hand. So from here, let me use green, the green color, to sketch the graph so that we can easily see what we are doing. So our green color is going to be used to sketch the graph. Okay, so from here, the graph will come like this. Okay, you see, I'm following the points that we were putting. Okay, using a free hand. Okay, so using a free hand, you have to know the shape of the curve and the way it's coming so that you can draw it nicely. Okay, so the curve continues, and here at 5, it ends up to there, then it goes up all the way up to where 21 is. Okay, so we have drawn our graph, and after drawing the graph, make sure you write the equation of the curve. So it's y is equal to x to the power 3, or x cubed, plus 4x squared plus x minus 5. Okay, so you write the equation of the curve. It doesn't matter where you write it, you can write it anywhere. So at this point now, we are now going to answer or to find the solutions of the following equation. So part two of the question, which says using a scale of 2 centimeters to 1 unit, we have actually drawn the curve. Here it is. So it's time now to answer the other questions that we have. So I'll now bring back the plain paper where we solved, or the paper where we solved the question for the first question here. It's going to help us. Okay, so here, for the first question here, which says use your graph to find the solutions. So part three of the question, I'm going to put part three of the question here. Part three of the question, which is A here. So here, which says use your graph to find the solutions of these equations that we have. So for the first one here, which is x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5 is equal to 0. So what you do here is, you get the original equation of the curve. The original equation of the curve is the one that you are given here above here, which is y is equal to x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5. So you write them side by side like this. And then you cancel them out. First, you make sure you compare the two. Make sure that they are the same. So in this case, this equation is the same as this one. So we've canceled these, and then we've remained with a y here. So we have y is equal to, and then here we've remained with 0. So y is equal to 0 is the equation of the x-axis. So since this is the equation of the x-axis, so we are supposed to come on our curve here and draw the x-axis. And so since the x-axis is already here, what we are going to do is we are just going to get the solutions now from this equation. So where the curve meets the x-axis, this green curve that you are seeing, where it meets the x-axis, that is where the solutions of the curve are, or of the equation are. So number one here, as you can see, at this point here on the x-axis, where the curve meets the the x-axis here. This is, you just count now from here, from 3, you have 1, 2. So that is at x is equal to negative 3.2. Okay, so from 3 here, you count 2 steps, that's negative 3.2. Another point is here, where the green curve meets the x-axis. So what you do is, since we always start counting from 0 this side, you can see that the curve is passing somewhere between negative 1 and negative 2. So that is about 1 point, when you count from this side, just count these small lines here, you are going to reach somewhere about, that's negative 1.8. So x is equal to, let me put it here, x is equal to negative 1.8. So you check on your curve, check on the curve here, where the curve meets the x-axis here. So you can count from negative 1 all the way up to there. Just count negative 1, the next line is negative 1.1, the next one is 1.2, until you reach 1.8 where it cuts the x-axis. And then you continue again somewhere else where it meets the x-axis at the point where positive 1 is, this side here. Here, you can see that the green curve meets the x-axis here at x is equal to 1. So you say x is equal to 1. So these are the solutions for the first question here, part A of the question, which says find the solutions for x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5 is equal to 0. So these are the solutions. Now we can go to the other part of the equation, the part of the question, which is part B of the question. So part B of the question, you will go into your answer booklet also, part B of the question, B, okay, part B of the question, we have part B of the question, which is x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5 is equal to 0. So once again, when you are given an equation like this to solve on the curve here, what you do is okay, so we go to the other part of the question, which is part B of the question. Part B. So we come to part B of the question. Part B of the question, which says x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 5 is equal to 2x plus 4. Okay, so this is the second part of the question, part B. So the way you solve this one also, you do it like the first one. You get the original equation and you write it side by side with this. So the original equation is y is equal to x cubed, that's a cube there, that's a 3, plus 4x squared plus x minus 5. And then you can compare this equation with what we have on top. So you notice that this part of the equation is the same as this part of the equation. They are the same, so you cancel them. Down here you remain with y, and then up here you remain with 2x plus 4 after you cancel. And so you have this equation of a straight line. So you have to draw this equation of a straight line. And so drawing this this straight line is a very simple thing. All you do is just generate a table of values. So you generate a table of values by choosing values of x at random. So randomly you choose the values of x. So let us draw a table here. We'll draw a table. Here is our table, x here, y there. And so we are going to choose values of x at random. So we can start with any value of x that we get from the x-axis here. So we can start with 0. We say, okay, if x is 0, what will y be? So we are going to substitute 0 where there is x there. We are going to have y is equal to 2 times 0 plus 4. So 2 times 0 is 0 plus 4. We are going to have 4. So it means y will be 4. And then you can choose any other value here that we have here. For example, you can choose 2, this positive 2 here. You can even choose negative numbers. So you say, okay, if x is 2, If x is 2, what is y going to be? So we are going to substitute this 2 where there's x there. So we are going to have y is equal to 2 times 2 plus 4, which will give us 4 plus 4, which will give us 8. So y will be 8. So here we are going to have 8. And so we have two coordinates here, 0, 4, this one here, and also 2, 8. So these two coordinates will help us to draw the graph of this straight line here. So you come to your graph here, this graph that we have drawn, and then you come and draw the graph of this straight line. So 0, 4, you come to the graph here. 0 is here, and then 4, remember that the scale is 2 to 5 here. From 0, you're going to 5. So it means you have to skip one line when counting. So from 0 here, you skip one line there, you have 1. Another one there, you have 2. Another one there, you have 3. And then there, you have 4. So our 0, 4 will be here. You put a mark. And then the next one is 2, 8. So our 2 is here. And so, 8, it's somewhere between 5 and 10 here. So you come where 5 is. And then you skip one line, you have 6. Skip another line, you have 7. Skip another one, you have 8. So our 8 is here. And so with these two points, this one here and this one, we can draw now the graph of a straight line. So we need a very long ruler, which we are going to use to draw this straight line. So allow me to use my board rule. So I'll use my board rule because it's longer than the pen that I was using. So put here, make sure the straight line is nicely drawn. Okay, so we are going to draw this straight line here. So we'll draw the straight line here like this. Okay, so we have drawn our straight line, and so this is y is equal to 2x plus 4. So y is equal to 2x plus 4. Now at this stage, we will need to get the solutions of our question from where the two graphs are meeting. The black line here that you are seeing and the green curve that you are seeing. Where they meet there, that's where the solutions are. So what you do is go where the two straight lines are meeting here. They are meeting here, they are intersecting here. And then you draw some nice dotted lines going to the x-axis. So here on the x-axis, that's where the solutions are. So get the value of x there. When you get the value of x there, that will be the solution. So that is at that point. So as you can see here, the curve and the straight line are meeting here. So you come down like this. And then there you have 1 is here, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. So you have 1.4, and then you record here, you say x is equal to 1.4, then you say x is equal to, and then you go somewhere again where the two are meeting. So we have another meeting point here, so we come down to the x-axis here, and that is negative 1.9. So you say negative 1.9 or x is equal to, you go to the other place where they are meeting. So here they are meeting here, so you go up like that. Remember, these are approximations. So here you get your value of x. So you go where the two are meeting, the straight line and the curve, and then you go up to the x-axis. So the solutions are found on the x-axis. So here this is somewhere between negative 3 and negative 4. So that is negative 3.12345. So negative 3, let me put it here, negative 3.5. And so once you have done this, you can now transfer your solutions to the graph in your exam. You can now transfer your solutions to the graph. So the first one that we found was this value of p, this one here. So you say, okay, a part 1, p is equal to 21, like this. And then the next one that we found was part 3 of the question, part 3a. So here we found x is equal to negative 3.2 x is equal to negative 1.8 and x is equal to 1. And then the last part of the question, part B of the question, we did all this stuff here and we found these solutions here. So part B, we have x is equal to 1.4, x is equal to negative 1.9, or x is equal to negative 3.5. And so this is how you find the solutions in your exam. So we have drawn the graph here, we have drawn this straight line, and we have also found the solutions by these methods that I was showing you. So the first one was this one here, where I showed you how to find these values here on the graph. And then the second part, part B, was this one here, where I showed you how to find also the solutions when you have an equation like this one. So thank you very much for paying attention.